Didn't know that. I didn't know that faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word, so you can take it home on the cassette so you can continue to hear. So listen, because I was naive that you could do that, that means that I wasn't getting what I needed until somebody showed me what was there. What if I didn't have that mentor? I'm just saying. Let me go on. He said also in Galatians 4, 1 and 2, he said, overseers or governors. See, the Bible says in Luke, if you've not been faithful in that which is another man's, who's going to give you that which is your own? Amen. Now, here's some questions that I ask people sometimes. Not necessarily ask them, but I just look. You ever find those people, they got wonderful ideas when it's their stuff. I mean, you put them in charge, they come up with a whole host of ideas. And you kind of go like, why never gave you any ideas when they weren't in charge? Does it only work when you're in charge? Or is it really you pushing your agenda? Oh, that don't happen in Terre Haute. That don't happen in Terre Haute. That's what that is. That's why y'all looking at me like, it don't happen in Terre Haute. Okay, that's fine. I understand. Y'all got it, you won't know. You know, in Acts 20 and 20, Paul said, I held back nothing that was profitable unto you.
Yes.
Okay, let me see if this happened in Terre Haute. You know, I noticed that you all are similar to us in regard of having universities here. So you have people like my young brother over here, skilled and versed in the academic arena.
Yes.
You know, and then these individuals, they begin to prosper and Pharaoh train them.
Mm-hmm. Well.
But I thought I read that Pharaoh trained Moses, but Moses came back and lifted his skills that he acquired from Pharaoh. How is it your church is going lacking and you possess the skill in a secular format? So you're telling me I'm really a hireling because I won't do it unless you... I didn't say you did. Because you're willing to do it on your job because they pay you. See, I'm just trying to understand how we climb the corporate ladder, but our church has never evolved. I'm just trying to find out how we know all of the latest technology in the corporate arena, but we don't bring it home. Unless we have our own agenda. Sorry, this is, y'all, I'm sorry, I'm thinking I'm at home, you know. I'm just going to... It also says at the end of verse 2 that there's a time appointed of the Father. The Bible says in Hebrews 5 and 8 that though he were a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he suffered. And the reference is to Jesus. So Jesus, as a son, learned obedience by what he was suffering. Why? Because fathers know how to discipline. See, you all are in a unique position. And I say this having lost, the late Bishop Lockett was my bishop. I've been with him for, he's the only pastor I've ever known. Loved him dearly. And the loss, I'm still affected by it. I'm just being honest. I learned that grief is not linear. Grief is cyclical. You could be riding in your car and all of a sudden it just come back and it hits you. You say what you want to. You call it however you want to call it. But I haven't had somebody that was that instrumental in me becoming what I am today. You call it what you want to. But you all are blessed because you have a patriarch in your midst. I know my assignment, why I came here, but I'm going to jump off and I'm going to say something. Lord, I almost cried just thinking about this, but I'm going to tell you, one of the things that blessed my wife and I to this day, when Bishop was alive, we honored him. Mm-hmm. when they called for the pallbearers, they said, Lady Lockett said, I want his sons as the pallbearers.
Yes.
And my name was called.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank God.
And he's got natural sons.
Yes.
Biological sons. And they were there. But it's good to know.
That's right.
See, I don't cry now because, I wish I would have done this. I honored him when he was here. I gave him his flowers when he was sick. I don't have a regret like that. I just miss him.
Yes, yes.
Saints, don't miss what God has given you. Because how you treat the man and the woman of God is how you treat God. Because you got to watch this. We are representatives of Christ in the earth.
Yes.
We represent Christ in the earth.
All right.
If we are representing Christ in the earth and you choose to neglect the representation of Christ, you are choosing to neglect Christ.
All right.
Well, okay, you don't like that? How about Malachi 3:11? You know Malachi 3:10. God says this, if I be a father, where then is my honor? I hear people talk, yes, so-and-so is my father in the gospel, so-and-so. If they're your father, why are you not honoring? See, show me they're your father by honoring.
Yes, sir.
See, James said, listen, my works will show you what I believe.
All right, sir.
See, we don't need lip service. Show me. Y'all got me off tonight, y'all. I'll be better tomorrow. But when Bishop Locke was here, my wife and I, he had put us over one of the other ministries that we had. All he did was pull his truck in. Get out of his truck, go in, breathe, come back. His truck was turned around, he drove off. Every aspect of ministry was done by a team of individuals who were not paid.
Praise God.
Not paid. See, honor. Why can't we honor? Why? You know what people had a problem with Jesus? Because he was God in the flesh. We have a problem honoring people that are in flesh for some reason. Oh, he's just a man. You right there, just a man, but a man of God. A man of God. That's the difference. Because this is the one who will speak the word that God gives him, and it changes your life.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
They become worthy of the honor.
Yes.
And then the Bible has the audacity to talk about double honor.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Well, I know this is not a...
That's
hallelujah. Oh boy, I feel my assignment pulling now because I feel something, and my wife told me to go with it when I feel it, and I'm trying to be good. I'm telling you, don't miss your moment. Every opportunity that you have to honor the man, the woman of God that's here, please do that. Don't be so bogged down in ministry that you miss what's real ministry. See, you don't want to become a Martha. See, Mary said, I'm sitting at the feet of Jesus. Martha said, I'm whipping up this nice meal. I'm going to impress God. Then she said, what is the problem, Jesus? I just don't understand. Jesus, don't you see me doing all of this? And Martha just sitting at your feet. I mean, and Mary just sitting at your feet. He said, Mary has found the right thing to do.
Yes.
See, here's one of the things about Jesus that a lot of people miss. Do you realize that Jesus wasn't holding classes? That's what he did. He taught people. Jesus would teach while he was going.
Yes.
If you don't make yourself available around a man and a woman,